In this video, we're computing the integral of 1 over x squared minus 4x. And actually, when I put this on the exam, I asked my students to use partial fractions decomposition on this. We actually did it previously by completing the square and using a trig substitution. So this was just another way of doing the same integral. Now, if we're going to use partial fractions decomposition on this, we need to factor the denominator. So we simply pull out a greatest common factor of x, and I have x times the quantity x minus 4. Now we make a partial fractions decomposition proposal. This integrand, 1 over x times x minus 4, should be expressible as a sum of two fractions, each of which has one of those factors in its denominator. Now we simply have to compute those coefficients a and b in the numerators. And the standard approach here is to multiply both sides by the least common denominator. So I distribute x times x minus 4 to every term. When I do that on the left-hand side, I just get 1. On the right-hand side, in the a containing term, a factor of x cancels, but the x minus 4 does not. And I get a times the quantity x minus 4. In the b containing term, the x minus 4 cancels, but the x does not, and I get b times x. This is one that can be solved quickly by using substitution. If I let x equal 4, I see that the a containing term vanishes, and I just get a 4b on the right-hand side, so 1 is equal to 4b. And that's the same as saying b is equal to 1/4. When we let x equal 0, we're able to kill off the b containing term, and I get 1 on the left-hand side, a times negative 4, or negative 4a, and the b containing term is gone because that's b times 0. So we find that a is negative 1/4. Now we can sub in a and b and rewrite the integral. So 1 over x times x minus 4 breaks into these two smaller fractions. The first one is negative 1/4 divided by x. And the second one is 1/4 divided by x minus 4. Each of those is a basic natural log integral. If I integrate 1 over x, I get the natural log of the absolute value of x. So I have negative 1/4 natural log absolute value of x. If I integrate 1 over x minus 4, that's just the natural log of the absolute value of x minus 4. So I get a plus 1/4 natural log of the absolute value of x minus 4. We'll put a plus c on there, and that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.